this can happen to anybody, right? By accident, even a 10-watt station. So, running a pile-up, it is quite an interesting... for a start off, we need to work out what's the definition of a pile-up. So I would say more than two or three people calling you for more than one over, if you know what I mean, or one contact. There is a this can happen to anybody, right? By accident, even a 10-watt station. You can call CQ. It happens to be a really nice spot frequency. Perhaps there was a DXer on there 10 minutes ago, and that frequency's on the cluster. Conditions are just perfect, and you get three people calling you, okay? Or four people. And maybe when you call QRZ after it, after you've had him, there's still four or five people. There's a pile-up. There's a way of just calming yourself down and just running that, and there's a really simple technique to it. But unfortunately, I have to use my pad here. Find a clean piece of paper. We'll go on the back of the hex beam. So, your call sign is M1ABC, all right? And you call QRZ M1ABC. And three or four people call you. So that's the start of time. Time is going that way. Three or four people calling you. Now, what happens is they start calling. So you end up with G1ABC calls there. I call you, M0MCX. Calls there in terms of time. There's someone else. There's a 2E0ABC. And just when you're about to key the microphone here, you hear another guy, right? G4ABC. So do you wait for him to finish before you key the microphone? And which one are you going to pick? Because all you've heard so far is you heard a G1. And then he got obliterated by an M's. At the same time, in the back of the set, you also heard as a 2E0 calling you. You're pretty certain, actually, you might have heard an M7ABC, whoever, right? You're just about to key the microphone because you're about to say, who's the G1, please? And then Golf 4 Alpha Bravo Charlie, really loud, calls you there. That's what I call the tail end Charlie technique. Had you give him the honours of knowing for a fact that when people shout their call signs, there's always this, you know, however many seconds there is between calling before you get back to him or not. I suggest as soon as you've heard the Golf 1 ABC or any of these early people, just because you can get his call sign in the log straight away, go to the early birds. And I'll tell you why. Because if you waited for G4ABC to finish, how do you not know there's a Mike 0ABC about to call here? And it gets to the point, well, how long do you want to wait before you get back to the pileup? So what I do, and this is the easiest way I've found, is that I give it this kind of standard pile-up duration, which I just made up. I give it the standard SPD. And then I call for one of these. And I do it like this. So I start, I key the microphone at this point, even though he's really loud, I'm going to go over the top of him. And I'm going to say, I'll pick one of these. Let's say I actually definitely hear there's a 2E0 in there. All right. I'll start saying here. And I go slightly longer than the standard pile-up duration. I say, right, I can hear a 2E0 there. A 2E0, please make your call. The reason for doing that is that if anybody decides in the initial standard pile-up duration to call again because he hears G4ABC. Now we go, we're still all going for it, are we? I'll go again. M0MCX. What happens is I make this slightly longer, about 1.5 times longer than the standard pileup duration, so that by the time I finished saying, who's the 2E0, 2E0, please go ahead, make your call, over, the pileup's gone silent because they won't key the microphone because they can hear me, right? So the pileup at this point in time, definitely about there, is silent. So even though I've keyed the microphone at this point in time, I've got G4ABC calling me, I've got Mike0ABC calling me, I've gone 1.5 times longer than the standard pileup duration. Just made that up, but you know what I mean. No one is going to start talking when they hear me. So by the time I've finished asking 2E0 to make their call, the pileup's silent. I've heard a couple of people, as soon as you, if you have a live stream, or as I said, I heard this guy with a 6 foot above the ground loop all the way around his backyard, his garden, on 80 meters. He couldn't believe it. I think he was doing 50 watts or something. And for some reason, he was super, super loud. And because he was super loud, he just had a pileup. And he did it really well. I think he used the standard pileup duration technique. And he would just key the microphone, even though there's a bubble of stuff going on here. There's a bubble of stuff going on here. But if you make this a little bit longer than your standard pileup duration, the pileup will be silent and the 2E0 will be able to make his call. That's it from Callum. I will see you on the next one. All the best. Bye for now.